theta is now pi, and then you add it with... Okay, in this video, I will show you guys how to integrate negative 1 to the x power from 0 to 1. And now you might be wondering, how in the world can we integrate this, right? Well, the truth is, not in the real world. Because, for example, x cannot be equal to 1 half. Otherwise, we will be getting the square root of negative 1. And that's a complex number, isn't it? So, in fact, we are talking about the complex world in this situation. And let me show you guys how to take of this. First of all, when we have a number to the x power in the integral, we actually want to deal with base e rather than base negative 1. So the first step is, let's try to think about how we can rewrite negative 1 in terms of e and maybe to the some power, okay? And to do so, we can actually use the Euler's formula. So let me show you. So let me put it down right here. We know that e to the I theta, this is equal to cosine theta plus I sine theta. Euler's formula, right? And now, I want to end up with negative 1. To make that happen, I can just make the real part to be negative 1, and hopefully I can kill the imaginary part, isn't it? And one angle theta that can make this happen is theta equals to pi. So I can just tell you, I will plug in pi into the theta, and we see that on the left-hand side, we will have e to the I pi, and that's equal to cosine of pi, and then we add it with I sine, and then the theta right here is still pi, of course. Okay, sine pi is 0. I times 0, this part is gone. This right here is negative 1. So in other words, you know, e to the I pi equals to negative 1. This is the famous Euler's identity, isn't it? And now, I will be looking at negative 1 as e to the I pi, and that's going to help us out. Let me continue. This right here is going to be the integral from 0 to 1, parentheses, I will write down e to the I pi, and then raised to x power dx, right? And then when we have a power to a power, we just multiply the powers, and we get the integral from 0 to 1, e still for the base, and then we have I pi times x, and then we have the dx right here. And now, I and pi, they're just constant, and when you multiply them, it's still a constant. E to a constant times x, to integrate that, we will first get this part, right? E to the I pi x, that stays the same, and you divide it by the derivative of this. The derivative of I pi x is just I pi, so I will just have 1 over I pi in the front. And then we plug in the values. We plug in the 0 and 1 and things like that. And now we have 1 over I pi. Open the parentheses. That's plugging 1 into here. So we have e to the I pi times 1 for the x. And then minus plugging 0 into here. So e to the I pi times 0 like that. Okay? In the end, we see that this is just 1 over I pi. This is just 1 times that, so it's still e to the I pi, which is, of course, still negative 1. So right here, we still have the negative 1 minus e to the 0, right, which is just 1. Minus 1 minus 1 is minus 2, times that is minus 2 over that, right? So you know this is equal to negative 2 over I pi, like this. And you are pretty much done. But you know, I don't like to be on the bottom, I like to be on the top. So let's multiply the bottom by I and also the top by I. And you see that on the bottom here, I times I give us I squared, which is negative 1. And negative 2 divided by negative 1 is positive. So we actually have 2i on the top. On the bottom, we will just have the pi. 2i over pi. This will be for my final answer for that. And in fact, this is just an answer to that integral. Why did I say this is just an answer? Blue chalk right here. So anyway, let's get back to here. Theta is equal to pi, that's what we used earlier, and then we end up with e to the I pi is equal to negative 1. And the deal is that when I plug in pi into cosine here, I end up with a negative 1, right? But the truth is, I can keep adding 2 pi to this angle, and then this is still going to hold, right? So in fact, I can say plus 2n pi. And when we do that, we can just plug in this right here for this data, which is right here. OK? And of course, right here, when we say 2n pi, n is just an integer. OK? It can be positive, it can be negative. This is just the notation for n being an integer. So for example, I can say, let's do pi plus 2 pi, which is 3 pi. When you plug in 3 pi, on the left-hand side, you will have e to the 3 pi I. And then that's equal to cosine of 3 pi, which is negative 1, plus I sine 3 pi, which is still going to be 0. Okay? And when you have that, when you add the 2n pi into this data here, which is the pi, well, you put the 2n pi here, right? And then you just add the 2n pi here, and then you can just add the 2n pi here, and then so on, so on, so on. So in the end, if you would like, you can just have this for the legitimate answer. 2i on the top over, I add 2n pi to this pi, and that's going to be right here, pretty much. So let me put down, this is the pi that we have, but now I will say plus 2n pi. Of course, this is 2i over factor of the pi, put that at the end, 2n plus 1, and then multiply by pi. This is how you get all the answer for that integral. This is so cool, isn't it? So hopefully you guys like this video, and thanks to my subscriber for sending me this question, and I really like it a lot. And yeah, as always, that's it.